I will tell you why today we cannot hear from the Holy Spirit. I'll tell you. Holy Spirit wants to speak with us. It is unfortunate because this has been happening for more than 2,000 years, whereby Christians who were having fellowship every day could not hear Holy Spirit, but the Spirit will be talking with people outside there. The angels will be visiting people outside there. But people in the church gathering, they will not even hear what God is saying. Look, by the time of when God wanted to convert Saul, the church in Jerusalem, no one was fit to approach Saul. Why God searching for someone outside in Samaria and goes to Damascus and just find someone who's praying? Today is because our churches are not focusing on winning souls. That is the first thing. When we start to have a mind of winning others, God will tell us about others. Let me say it again. If we start to have the mind of thinking about other people who are lost, what will happen is the Lord started to tell us about others. He will send us to other people. Today, our focus is what we can get. When we come to church here, receive. Things that we were supposed to be following us, and the things that we are praying for them now, things that God has given us. You know, in the Bible, it says that in the book of Matthew 6, God knows what we want before we even tell him. God knows what we want before we even tell him. So today, we have problems because our focus is not souls. Our focus is what can we get, which we have been presented already by faith. We can get everything pertaining to your life. What is the reason why today we have problems that... Because what devil wants to do, he wants us to be directed away from this mission. Directed away from the great mission. We are already away now. We are not focusing where God wants us to go. God has not been a God who failed. Today, people are fighting each other in the church. Competition in the church. Problems everywhere. Not long when I was coming here, I saw one man was poisoned. Because they say he's exposing people. Christians against Christians. Church against. No one is having a heart of crying for the lost. I pray that today we change our focus from the things of the world. Things of the world will follow us. I'm saying this because I've got grounds to say that. I started to be a pastor without a cent. I I lost everything. And me and my wife, we pray to get those things. We never get them. If prayer can make someone rich, I was supposed to be very rich more than 20 years ago. I don't know if you're hearing me. If prayer make someone to be very rich. Me, I was supposed to be a billionaire. Even yesterday, I woke up, I was praying. I was supposed to have gotten maybe 10 million yesterday. But these are the things we are crying to get. Not knowing that God has already given us. I don't know if you're hearing me. Just say, you're already blessed. Why are you searching for blessing? You're already blessed. What you have to do is to position yourself and start to think about those who are lost. Do you know that in the church we're not supposed to be knowing each other? We're supposed to be knowing how many you brought in the church. Can you tell a neighbor, in the church, you're not supposed to be knowing who is around you. He was supposed to be knowing how many you brought in the church. How can you cram? If every Sunday you are bringing 10 people, another one is bringing 20 people, another one is 15. Because you are bringing nobody, you know each other. You compete each other. You even go to those fishes that have been taken, you take them. Those fishes will give you problems because they've been fished before. They've got experience of being fished. This is the time that all of us, we get out of people in the house of God. We start to seek other people who are lost. This is not a commission for pastors, it's for everyone. Pastors are there to edify the church. If truly you have found other people that truly you found your salvation, and your salvation is important, why don't you tell your friend? Can you just tell your neighbor, if you truly have found Jesus and Jesus is powerful for you, why don't you tell your brother? Oh. Are
you hearing me?
If
indeed you find that Jesus is the right one, and you are in a certain church, why are you unable to tell your own friend? Why are you unable to tell the next person that you come to church? That's the thing that makes the Lord not to speak anything. God is not speaking anything because we are looking at each other in the church. That is why we are always fighting each other. things are not happening and going well. We are looking each other in the eyes. We don't pray. We are only competing.
You are just analyzing yourself.
Fighting
each other. This is the time that if truly you found your church, if you found that your salvation
in that church is important,
how can you spend 6 months without bringing your brother? Even your neighbors, they don't even know
yourself. I can go
and say, sorry, you know where I come from. There's a man of God there. Let's go in fellowship.
Accept
Jesus there. This is what I was doing. Me, I didn't start to be a pastor. I was in the church. I was with Mama. Mama was shaking the floor.
Mama never fear la face.
Whoever I meet, sorry.
Are you a Christian?
I'm born again. And you can come to our church. I didn't have too much words in the Bible.
Except talk about
come to church
and
accept Jesus. Jesus will heal you. I began to see problems of people. I began to dream people. Go where you'll meet this one. I go there, I meet a person. Hey, I dreamed you. There's, you're about to die. There's something like this. Me, yes. I met people. I've been sended. There was a day where I was sended. I was coming from work. I was still a member. I was standing very close to that woman. And then I was told that I'm going to meet this woman. She will be wearing this coming from where? In Park Station. From here, up here, she's surely. This thing will go up. If you don't pray for her, she will die. And her blood will be counted on. Meaning that you have sinned against the Holy Spirit. The moment when I come from Maraisberg, when I learned, I'm coming out of training, it's not landing, but I must not make training special. Mama, what must you say? When you come from the train, when you were shoot out. No, say when you were shoot out like a bullet from the train. Interpret, Mama.
Okay.
When I was shoot out. From the train. The moment when I look at the left side, I saw that mama. I was afraid. I said, God, how can you do this to me? And then, what must I do? I was speaking alone. I heard a voice, go closer. I went to stand with her like this. But I didn't know she was beautiful. And I can't pray with her on Park Station. And people are moving. I began to say, sorry,
sis.
She says, what?
I
say, you are sick. She says, how do you know? I
say,
you are swollen from your
knees.
This thing wants to kill you. Now, it goes back here. She began to cry.
Hysterically.
I say, I don't know you. How do you know my problems?
As I by God.
But because there were people around there, when she was crying, I was afraid to pray for her like this. I said, I can pray for you. I put my hand like this. I was like, I'm trying to say she must
not be.
When I'm doing like this, she says, oh, I'm feeling something. There's something that is coming out of me. I said, please don't fall down. Because I don't have an usher here. Because I know. And then when I was doing like that, I said,
hey,
no, go, you are free. Go send me, you are free. She began to say, yes, I could not do that. Yes, I could not. Oh, hey, I'm healed. I disappear. Can I tell you this? Think about how many people we are failing
there.
How many die by your ignorance? How many die by your disobedience? When you are still focusing to get a house and a car and a job, how many people are dying in front of you? I pray that today you overcome this ignorance. Overcome this ignorance. It's a shameful one.
Yes, service.
Pastors are waiting to edify the church. You are just coming.
When out of hell.
Making friendship in the church. My friend.
Mamfundisi.
And why are you doing this?
And why would you do this?
I pray that today you overcome your ignorance. I say overcome your ignorance. When you come to church, if you are failing to win many, serve him. Serve him. Do something there. Without looking at anyone. Whoever comes your way to worry your spirit. Because some people have been planted by Satan. To come and worry you. So that you stop what you're doing. It happens to me and Mama. We reach the church called Miracle Christian Church. And then when we are starting to serve, Mama says, let's buy grocery for our pastor. I was still working by then. And then people came to us. The old Madalash. The tokoloshis of the church. They came to me. Came to Mama. And say, you know, do you know this church divided 3 times?
The thing that you are doing, this pastor does not hear from God.
Sorry, say, see.
And we say sorry. We are not doing it for the pastor. We are doing it for God.
I pray that you people, you overcome this.